The WWE Universe with an electric feeling here tonight. We are sold out and raring to go.
I am amped up, pumped up, jacked up, and ready to kick things off. What are we waiting for, fellas? Let's watch some fights.
So we are here with our first matchup of the night, and coming off EPW lockdown, what a pay-per-view that was. Jack Hayabusa picking up the title, and of course he will face the returning Jet Morningstar later tonight. Now Kyle Oxley making his debut here in EPW, and he will take on Michael Kidd. And it seems Eric Jones has his eye on Michael Kidd. Of course, Eric Jones, the knockout champion, and we know he defeated Ken Woods to capture that title, and of course Michael Kidd, the protege of Ken Woods, so you know, only makes sense that Eric Jones is keeping an eye on Michael Kidd. Of course, this Extreme Rules matchup won't be easy. Kyle Oxley looking to prove himself here tonight. Now as Michael Kidd makes his way to the ring. And of course, and we've seen his performance last week. He wasn't able to pick up a victory, but he'll look to pick up a win here tonight. He looks ready. Determined, you can just see the look on his face.
What a great match we have here to start off this night, guys. And Michael, I had to check twice when I saw this match listed as our opener. I mean, it could very well.
And of course, also later tonight, Austin Blade in action after losing that title to Rory Pierce. And the Prestige take on Deathsaw. As this matchup gets underway,
this should be an incredible matchup. I mean, both men have extensive
and a knee to the back of the neck and a lasting neck breaker.
And an insatiable appetite to be number one.
And man, I never get tired of watching these guys.
Now, Michael Kidd pushing him off. The left hand there, and now misses that second punch and a knee. And Enziguriyan.
And there are no disqualifications.
Eric Jones. We said he'd be keeping an eye on him, but didn't think he'd come watch by ringside, and I don't think he's watching. As he picks him up for that choke slam, straight down an Extreme Rules match, no DQ. Just like that, he's out of here. The referee can't do anything. And wow, it looks like we could, I mean, we'll have to wait and find out. We'll try and see why Eric Jones has done that, but Kyle Oxley tries to regather himself after that. Enziguriyan, looks like the knee connected. Michael Kidd making his way up, trying to get to his feet, but Kyle Oxley now with the advantage. Let's see how that will play later into this matchup, and an elbow to the knee. Now he punches that knee pad. And so much for keeping an eye on him. Well, looks like we'll just, you know, come to the ring and do as he pleases.
He shrugs it off and comes back more motivated than ever.
Yeah, he's taking on some offense here, but that's to be expected, especially.
Of course, also Jay Mamba. We're interested to see what happens on Destruction. Of course, you know, losing the knockout matchup.
I guess we'll just have to set.
We gotta come hurry.
You know, pin one. No, just a one count kick out and a kip up.
Way too early.
Now, boot right to the face. Shoulder just knocks down Kidd. You see, knee to the back, neck breaker.
Breaker, man, just ugly impact.
Man, it's a kid with a shoulder block. He picks him up with a slam over the. Okay, a bit of a power slam that was. And he picks him up for a gut wrench suplex.
What impact!
He's on the defensive here.
Now, kid on the outside of the ring. Looks like he goes searching for a weapon.
Punishment tonight. You don't step in the ring with this guy and walk away completely unscathed. This is all part of the process.
And a chair right to the face. And of course, Extreme Rules. He chucks that chair out.
He keeps it to a minimum.
Into the pin. One, two, three, and Michael Kidd picks up a victory. Of course, Eric Jones not affecting this matchup whatsoever. The outcome of this matchup, Michael Kidd, I think, just became more determined to pick up a win after Eric Jones's interference. Unfortunately, Kyle Oxley wasn't able to pick up victory. I think that chair shot of the head just ended it. One, as we said, the pin, two, three. Michael Kidd, would you see the look on his face?
And the first match of the night comes to
let's see how pumped he looks after that win.
The performance put forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event.
Stay tuned for the next matchup. You won't want to miss it. So we are here with the second matchup of the night, and it is Amir Bates taking on Alexander Volkan. Balcon, I believe I said it right. And as he makes his way down to the ring, Amir Bates. We should name that arrow. As everything lights up, he looks behind him just to make sure no one's coming out after him.
Making his way to the ring from Dresden.
He looks worked up, and of course, you can see he's not happy after that loss at lockdown. Wasn't able to capture that title.
Big time singles.
Now Jack Haibusu won that matchup, and what a shock that was.
All day to get their hands on each other.
And of course, Jack Haibusu is in action later tonight. And that will be a match you won't want to miss. Makes his way to the ring. Alexander Volkan makes his way to the ring. I just said that, but of course it'll be interesting to see how he goes here tonight in this matchup. I mean, pretty impressive in the chamber. Inside the chamber, of course, I think the element of surprise may have played a part there. No one knew he was even signed with EPW.
We have one-on-one action on the way, and this one should be nothing short of amazing.
The element of surprise able to help him out there.
Go so far as to say this match.
But he takes on Amir Bates, and there is no element of surprise here tonight. Amir Bates is ready. Not someone I'd be wanting to step in the ring with. Angry, I mean, Amir Bates in general, when he's not angry after a loss, he's not someone I'd want to step in the ring with. But after coming off EPW and a loss, after coming out of EPW lockdown with a loss, I wouldn't want to step in a ring with him. Amir Bates has got a point to prove. And I think he's going away in an uppercut. I don't know where he just lifts him up and
about this one-on-one
connects
matchup.
Him with an uppercut. An elbow to the back. Now in the corner, and Amir Bates with a drop kick. Now again in the corner. No, Amir Bates not able to get that drop kick. And an elbow there. And he grabs him a deep six. Picks Amir Bates up. Alexander.
What a slam.
The slam.
Oh, the referee better get a hold of things. He's taking some offense.
Now into the pin.
It's going
one.
To take more than that to keep
one
his
count just
down.
There.
Nah, not yet. Too early.
Now punch here by Amir Bates and snap me. Irish rip again into the corner.
Technique.
And he connects this time with a, I'd say like a clothesline sort of thing.
You gotta believe
and a knee right to the gut. Right to the side of the gut and the rib. And a jawbreaker.
You can pick up your teeth in the third row.
Now into a submission here. Is he get those legs? I'm looking at pain on Alexander's face. As he lets it go there.
Now, this could be the start of an ugly downward spiral if he's not careful.
He picks him up in a sit-out powerbomb. He's beat 1-2.
From a three count, I can tell.
Two count there.
What a kick out! He's looking.
Amir Bates will look to finish things off. He picks him up in DDT.
Might be the opportunity he needed.
Spiked him.
Look at this.
Head first. One. This will be it. Good night. Two and no. A kick out. Alexander somehow able to kick out and now putting that arm behind his head in a submission.
Is he done?
Alexander may have no choice but to tap out. You know, there's a few knees to the back of the neck.
Whoa, he works his way.
Great thinking by Alexander.
Job right there.
And a neck breaker.
Ooh.
And a DDT.
He got body up.
Two, I think that was just a one count or two count. Nowhere near enough to put him away anyway. Look at the cuts on Amir Bates. Take a look at him if you can. And just that cut on his back, that is a very deep cut.
Oh boy, he is rolling. Here he goes.
And picks him up and slam. One.
Can he end it here?
Two. No.
Have to put in a lift.
I don't know if he let him out or Amir Bates kicked out. I think Amir Bates managed to get his shoulder up.
Man. I like this aggression, just pure brutality.
Not easy.
Picks him up and he grabs him. Rocks bottom.
I knew it was only a matter of time. Now that got those shoulders on him.
One, two, and two count there in the crowd. You can hear him chanting. This is awesome. Alexander, disbelief there. And Amir Bates kicked out, but that's really no surprise. Bates doesn't go down without a fight.
He's stumbling some now. And at this point, how much more does he have to give?
This match is trending in a bad direction drops right now, guys. He's going to want to make some changes.
Bates seems to be enjoying this.
Sure, he'd rather not be on the receiving end here.
A shoulder block. Another shoulder block. Now, Alexander not able to get rid of Bates. As Bates goes up top.
Wow, kicking butt.
And an axe handle.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
He picks him up. A sit out power slam. One, two, three. And Amir Bates able to pick up the win.
And the victory.
Not much of a surprise there. Amir Bates, like I said, had a point to prove.
Big victory. And
he proved that point here tonight.
Superstar.
Alexander on those ribs. And we've seen, of course, those knees earlier, and they're targeted. Looks like Amir Bates isn't finished. Trying to get a point to prove and attacking him. This is what's the point in this? The match is over. Let Alexander be. Bounces right off that apron. Irish whip into those stairs. His shoulder first.
Judging from the vibe here currently, it seems to me like this is the one this sold-out crowd came to see.
And so we are here with this next matchup, Austin Blade, James Sabre, and Atomic Drop.
One-on-one, mano-a-mano.
Oh man, this is going to be great.
And a reverse DD to STO. And James Sabre out of the corner.
Oh, what's it going to be?
And suplex. Austin Blade in control here. James Sabre with an arm drag. Kick to the back as he picks him up. Austin Blade grabs that arm and just yanks it over the top of his shoulder. Now, one on one here, these men going at each other. Now, Austin Blade rolling out of the ring. He wants nothing of James Sabre.
Looks like this superstar's trying to take a minute to.
James Sabre telling him to get back in the ring, but doesn't want anything of him. It was Roy Pearce. Panjari sends him back in.
Throwing them back into the ring.
As the match continues. And a kick to the leg. Chop block there. See that knee, James Sabre, grab it. You take out the knee, Nenziguri. James Sabre just goes falling off the apron. And I was about to say, you take out that knee, effectively won the matchup.
Sometimes,
if you can't walk, then you can't really continue the matchup, and it's a super kick. Right to the chin.
He still has plenty of fight left in him.
Targeting the stomach. Harsh impact.
He goes bouncing off that apron head first. Referee up to the count of five.
Six.
And guys, if this is a normal matchup, then why didn't Roy Pearce get DQ'd?
Dangerously close to getting counted out.
Definitely cutting it close, Michael.
And the referee just kind of forgot.
And he's heading
Austin Blade now in the ring.
Beautiful technique.
Double knees once again. Now an elbow. And a clothesline into the corner. You see the way Austin Blade just kind of rattled against that corner.
He's on the defensive here. He's really going to need to create some space for himself.
And a kick to the chest.
Some offense here, but that's to be expected, especially considering who he's in the ring with.
He's going for the pin.
Now pin one, and nowhere near enough. Austin Blade is kicking out easily at one. Now it's James Sabre. Puts Austin on the ropes. An Irish whip.
What a strike.
And an elbow. He spins out of it. Arm drag there. Just chucks him off those ropes.
Ollie.
Oh, front Russian leg sweep or front face buster, and James Sabre now with that stomp. We've seen to do it a few times before here in EPW.
He's struggling a bit here.
Called an elbow there.
If he could recover from this, guys.
Man. That confidence he had on his face at the start of this match.
And a sling blade.
Disappeared, and with good reason. He's taken quite a beating.
It's beat six by Austin Blade.
But he's got a count.
That went very smoothly as well. One, two. Two count there, James Sabre. You see him get the shoulder up.
More damage.
Now's Austin Blade stalking Sabre. He spins him around and knee to the face. Clothesline.
Physicality of this match.
James Sabre doing the smart thing and rolling to the apron. He has a punch here, knocks down Sabre.
Oh, what's it gonna be?
Now snap suplex. Oh, suplex. Nonetheless. Trying to lift him up, but not able to. James Sabre getting some punches in his kick, but no, he catches that.
He's gonna need to make some changes.
Here we go, a few kicks, he catches that kick, but Blade one step ahead. Misses that cross body. James Sabre now back in the ring. He grabs that leg and brings him down into the ropes. Now inverted power slam, that will hurt. It could be the beginning of the end for James Sabre. Now face first. That is the end. One, two, and no. James Sabre kicking out. Look at the desperation on the face of Sabre, given that everything he had.
Quick thinking to avoid that one. He might have it.
How we've seen is bridging powerbomb, well, bridging package powerbomb. Power bomb. We see this could be it. One,
left,
two, three, and James Sabre is able to pick up a win.
What a win.
What a win for James Sabre, and what a match that was.
We've got some time to take another look at some of the highlights from that one.
And of course, as we know, Austin Blade and Roy Pearce was announced just before this matchup. The winner of Match of the Year.
Oh, I can't believe this.
You see that stomp? of course, happened just at the EPW lockdown. Very well deserved. Set a pin too, and save it kicking out there. Well, we all thought this was over. See that desperation. And here just James Sabre able to counter. And able to pick up the win.
Here is your winner, the technician, James the Savior, Saban.
Big victory for him here in this one. That was simply a case of one guy determined to prove his...
James Sabre picking up a victory.
We must now move on.
Much needed victory as well. Stay tuned for our next matchup. And Alex Sizely making his way to the ring. And, well, we now reveal a superstar of the year, which is nonetheless Eric Jones, who's had a very impressive year. We've seen him earlier tonight. I've heard last match, Roy Pearce, Austin Blade, match of the year. Eric Jones able to pick up superstar of the year. And of course, next match, our tag team matchup, we'll find tag team of the year. Alex Sizely makes his way to the ring. And he's focused. Calm, and he knows his way around these ropes. Of course, come a long way from when he first started here in EPW. A part of a tag team, Alex Sizely, when he first started. They faced the Outlaws in their first matchup, and well, his tag partner suffered a career-ending injury, and Alex Sizely had to finally turn to singles competition. And so here he is now, Alex Sizely, pretty impressive, I must say. As he takes on Cody O'Ryan here tonight. Two very decent competitors. Cody O'Ryan makes his way to the ring.
From Kyoto, Japan, weighing in at 227 pounds, the Super
See Cody O'Ryan make his way to the ring. Of course, Cody O'Ryan, quite the star.
This will be one we won't soon.
He is a D-Wall. He has a tag team championship against his name here in EPW, and that was a while ago, but he's completely different then. He's completely different from then to his now. Probably making his way to the top here in EPW, proving that he's can be one of the best stars on the roster. You just see that attitude of his, just really doesn't really care what anyone else thinks about him. He just comes here, does his business, which is wrestle, and leaves. Over the top, float over DDT.
To be number one. Settle in, guys. This is going to be a blast to watch.
Now an elbow face right to the top of the head. Alex Sizely able to shake that kick to the back off. The Irish whip bouncing off the corners. You see the strength of Cody O'Ryan as he targets that arm.
Uh-oh.
Now a slim roll here. He's trying to wear down Alex Sizely. reversal there, and now collar and elbow tie up. And Cody O'Ryan just clothesline over the top, sending Alex Sizely to the outside of the ring. A kick to the stomach, a chop there. Elbow to the back. Alex Sizely able to gain some momentum here. Count of four now.
That's going to leave a mark. He's not looking like himself.
You see him bounce off that concrete. Count of six now.
And what he has to do to rebound.
Sure, he's taking some punishment.
And a neck breaker.
She prefers to be on the outside of the ring.
I want to get back inside the ring. Arm drag.
One shot. Yeah, but if you count him out now, guys,
eight.
Very big mistake.
It's awfully close here.
Now that'll do some serious
damage. Nine, a count of nine, using up every second on the outside they can. And of course, I must say that is a very smart move. More damage you do on the outside of the ring, it much easier it makes it when you're on the inside. And Cody O'Ryan taking it back outside the ring. Alex Sizely dropping to one knee. A chop there. Referee telling him to get back in the ring.
Well, what's it going to be?
Now an underhook suplex. Count of five and
six.
Slamming Sizely face first into that apron. He bounces off. Count of seven. Cody O'Ryan may just let this end via count out.
Nine.
Looks like Cody O'Ryan is
such a favorable spot.
Smart move.
Come on, not like this.
By Cody O'Ryan. I'll give him that. Not the way I wanted to see this end. Not the way anyone wanted to see this end, but nonetheless, it's a victory. Of course, we see that count out.
Here is your winner, the Super Athlete.
Alex Sizely won't be impressed, and we see him on the outside there.
I'll tell you, going out like that is a tough.
Trying to get his breath back. Taken in the crowd. And we are here with our tag team match, and it's about time we reveal the tag team of the year, which is Lucky 13. Of course, Eric Jones, a part of that team, and he also picked up Superstar of the Year earlier tonight, but Lucky 13 not in action here. Deathsaw will take on Prestige. AJ Reese and Justin Kendrick will take on Matt Bailey and Philip Sheffield.
Guys, we have a big time tag team match coming up here.
Those two men weren't able to pick up a victory at lockdown. Not these two, but the Prestige. So they'll look to change things up here and hopefully pick up a win and maybe, you know, have another shot at those titles. But imagine if these two men were able to defeat the Prestige. That may very well put them in title contention. Because these two men undefeated, and they'll look to continue their undefeated streak here tonight. But a team that's about to come, the Prestige, aren't going to go down easy. And is that Scott Osborne?
Your opponent, accompanied by Philip Sheffield.
Oh, Philip Sheffield.
At a combined weight
on the right.
190 pounds.
At the back there, and Matt Bailey at the front.
And Scott Osborne.
And Scott Osborne, yes it is. Wow. Scott Osborne will make his way to the ring for action. We haven't seen Scott Osborne in ages. I mean, last time we seen him, I mean, we haven't seen him since the Prestige return. I mean, when they re-signed, the Prestige didn't want bring Scott Osborne back, but now they've brought in the reinforcements. And I can only assume if they brought Scott Osborne back, we will see Enzo. Of course, you keep up to date with Ring the Bell Wrestling. I first of all do recommend them, but the Prestige Tag Team Champions, been Tag Team Champions for well over a year, from what I know, a year I believe it is. I think they held them through most of 2020, if not all of 2020. Of course, one of the best tag teams in the industry at the moment. As we see Scott Osborne there, what a return this is. See them get ready for action.
The tag team action underway here.
And whichever team wins this match here tonight can absolutely make an argument for being one of WWE's.
You see Matt Bailey and AJ Reese starting things off. And a teardrop back suplex. I think more of a teardrop suplex, but nonetheless. Now we see an Irish whip. And ducks underneath with a German suplex. And an elbow to the back, right on that spine.
He might have it.
He's definitely starting to lose it here.
You see, he's able to get out of that one.
Man, he just has so much resolve.
And no, shoulder first into that turnbuckles. You see, he tried to just dig that shoulder into the gut of AJ Reese, but AJ able to get out in time. Wonder how that will play effect on the power slam. Into the pin. One, just a one count.
Not yet. Oh, look at this, raining down sharp elbows.
And a knee. To the face. As he makes a tag, Matt Bailey slowly getting back to his feet.
Harsh impact.
And a chop. Now another
big time
suplex this time. Exploded suplex. And a kick to the back, and Justin Kendrick just able to shake it off, and an enziguri.
What a stomp. Good grief.
And of course, Deathsaw also made up a crom.
What an uppercut.
And an uppercut. Catches him in the throat there. Now managed to dig that shoulder in. He gets it this time. And over the top. An overhead suplex. An elbow. Another elbow.
Right to the sternum.
Just elbow one after another.
Stomp your heart.
Six. Seven. Eight. Nine.
One more for good.
10 elbows in the chest, that will hurt you. I'm sure that will even leave a bruise.
The teams became very familiar with one another. In June of 2017, the teams met in a 2-3
knee right, boot to the face, I should say.
Fall in a 2-3 falls contest is the first.
He ducks under in a German suplex.
That sets the tone for the
Justin Kendrick needs to make a tag.
He
gets some sort of offense in the knee to the face.
The 2-3 falls match you saw the Hardy Boys go at it with Cesaro and Sheamus was a throwback of sorts. Throughout the 1960s and 70s, championship title defenses and grudge matches.
And a boot to the face.
Three falls format.
Now an Irish whip.
Sheamus didn't waste any time and scored the decisive.
And again an elbow.
Kick rocked.
knee. Oh, sorry. Shoulder.
To continue their domination of Team Extreme.
Picks him up. DDT off the shoulder. In the pin one. It's a one count.
He didn't win this match right there.
It's going to take more than that.
A kick to the back. And Justin Kendrick, once again, just able to shake it off. And knee to the face. Stuns Matt Bailey.
Partner looked extremely confident.
Justin Kendrick should probably use this opportunity to make a tag. He chooses not to, and that may prove costly. I'm surprised Matt Bailey hasn't made a tag yet, I'll be honest. And then a reversal, another Enziguri. And now Phillip Sheffield getting involved, using the numbers game to their advantage. That is no surprise.
This tag team match is dangerously close.
Taking the momentum away.
If you told me heading into this match that he was
from Deathsaw, now we've seen this a few times before.
Especially you, Saxton.
The knee. Kick to the knee.
But if you're counting him out now, you haven't been.
And he will also receive a knee to the back, just for good measure.
Anybody on the roster.
And another knee to the back. Scott Osborne now in action.
He's in trouble. Big move coming.
Now kick to the gut and DDT.
He's in complete control now.
Into the pin. Will this be it? One. Two, and a kick out by Scott Osborne.
He's here tonight for a fight, and that's exactly what we are seeing.
Stomp right underneath that arm.
My goodness. Go clothesline!
Now clothesline there, and another clothesline. Another clothesline by Justin Kendrick.
That's the way they drew it up. Oh boy, he is rolling.
Now reversal.
That one.
Now knee to the gut. Up on the middle rope, and then elbow as he goes flying across the across the ring. As they make a tag, we see here.
Nasty impact. How much more punishment needs to be?
They make advantage of that tag.
To be at this point in this tag team
match. Spine buster.
Spot.
He's rattled you.
But he's running on fumes here. Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
Now an elbow. Chest. Once again. As I said earlier, that tag, that missed opportunity for a tag will come into play here. He's already seen it. Shoulder to the gut.
The belly.
What we see is he looks to make the tag. Now we see a gut wrench suplex here. Now a gut wrench power bomb. One, two, and able to break it up or able to kick out anyway. Now he picks him up in a uranoki slam by AJ Reese. Matt Bowen nonetheless focused on Justin Kendrick.
And
a kick to the back of the neck. Justin Kendrick just picking up Scott Osborne.
We've seen some great.
Definitely needs to make a tag.
Here in WWE, and I can attest that this is no different.
A shin breaker.
You got
Dragon screw. Of course, keeping him over their side of the ring. Smart move. And a sit-out powerbomb. One. And taking out the referee.
At this point, too early in the match to end it. Slam down.
Slam there. AJ Reese going face first.
It's a reversal. And now one more time.
Justin Kendrick.
Wow.
Into the pin. One. And Scott Osborne there to break up the pin. These two just staring at each other. Intensity of that stare. I could feel that from the commentary table.
I gotta say,
a back body drop.
Power rankings. I thought there was a misprint. There's no way this superstar deserves such a favorable ranking.
Underhook suplex. into a pin. Will this be it? One, two, and no. AJ Reese.
Just as shocked as everyone else, Cole. His opponent
is ready to break that up.
Making a statement here with this attack.
I see him just spin him around.
Hooked up in the corner.
Exploded suplex in the corner. AJ Reese reaching out for a tag.
This might be it. Oh my.
Now we see he drops him up top and a moonsault.
Beautiful.
Split legged moonsault. Into a camel clutch now.
Yeah, I wonder why.
And rope break there.
Tagged in.
Now as he makes a tag. Grabs the arm, just brings it over his shoulder. And kicks the gut. And a running neck breaker there. Talking trash, AJ Reese.
Uh-oh. Oh, a snap there. That'll give you whiplash. Oh, and he dodges out of the way.
Now Matt Bailey. Another underhook suplex.
Oh, what impact! He's struggling a bit here. He needs to find.
You see that sit-out powerbomb,
guys. Yeah, but the good news is that he still appears to be in better condition.
Now an Irish whip into the corner and double knees to the back.
There he goes. That was impressive, Cole.
Now it's Matt Bailey. Looks to set up to finish things off. And a German suplex.
But that's not all.
And that grip, or that clothesline, is turning him inside out. You see him take a trip around the world.
Gets the shoulder up in time. How in the world?
And an elbow. Brainbuster by Justin Kendrick.
To find a way to create some space or else this thing's over. He has got to fight back.
AJ Reese now. Philip Sheffield watch on, watches on.
Harsh impact.
Clothesline. Another clothesline. A calf kick.
But he's got to capitalize now.
Death's all definitely not going down without a fight.
Uh-oh. I think I know what's about to happen.
And no, as he reverses that kick, he gets out of the way. And a slam. AJ Reese just straight back up. Having none of that slam and an elbow to the back of the head. Watch the way he just collapses on his knees.
In up the tag.
Tag there. Just collapsed on his knees. He just gave way after that elbow. It was kind of scary. AJ Reese on the outside there.
Escapes trouble there.
An uppercut. Catches him with a suplex.
Locked in.
Now can't quite see what's going on the outside, but something is an elbow there.
Should be getting coached up right now.
And a spine buster.
That might just be the final nail in the coffin. That should do it, Cole. There's
now German suplex.
Uh-oh, he's in trouble here.
Now another German suplex.
But that's not all.
Oh. A clothesline which turns him inside out.
His opportunity to win this thing. Shoulders down.
One, two. That would kick out.
Unbelievable. I can't believe it. He just won't go away. Perhaps a powerbomb here, Corey. That certainly seems to be the case.
As we see. Looks like he's going to carry him across the ring.
I think you're right.
Buckle bomb. Justin Kendrick trying to make that tag. I wouldn't be letting that go. AJ Reese, nonetheless, they let it go. Scott Osborne on the receiving end of a knee and straight back up. And a pile driver. See him roll out there.
But how much energy?
And clothesline. No, Ezra have been in the corner. And no, that knee. Kind of trading that turnbuckle.
I don't think there are two teams I'd rather see square up.
Just bounce off that post there. Off the turnbuckle.
Nobody controls the pace of a match.
No, Irish whipping. Looks like Matt Bailey was distracting the referee.
Tremendous ring presence from the apron.
And Matt Bailey with a punch there.
Tagged in.
Of course, when Deathsall first made their name, first when they made their appearance here, they attacked the Prestige and Odin's Omen.
Tagged in.
An elbow drop to the back.
Uh-oh.
Justin Kendrick looks to finish things off. I wouldn't turn around. Matt Bailey with a receiving end of the knee.
Here he goes.
The referee numbers game involved here.
He breaks up the pin.
Sorry, Philip Sheffield getting things involved. Oh, as that may have been the end there.
Oh, he turns in
German.
The cover.
Into the pin.
One. Two.
And, he gets the and no. Amazing. Awfully close there.
Thinking. Does he not want to win?
Now Matt Bailey. Three
there it is. The tag
tags in Scott Osborne.
Needed that in the worst way, Michael.
Don't know what happened there, but face first. Now he looks to finish things off with a kick to the chin. This could definitely be it.
Impressive, but you got to be careful if you go to the well too often.
And a reversal.
Beautiful technique.
And a close line there.
Oh, and he connects. There's no reason. He's got him covered.
Into the pin. One.
Two.
And a two count there.
How did he do that?
Justin Kendrick breaking things up.
And
a knee to the face.
That's gonna hurt. He's playing with him now.
This looks like it may be it.
He's looking at it.
No, a reversal.
Look at it.
He picks him up, spins him around with a clothesline.
Perfectly.
Is he able to get it?
One,
two, and no, a two count kick out. Awfully close there. Of course, neither of these two teams want to go down without a fight. Neither of these two teams want to lose. And he ducks underneath that and grabs it with his knee there. Scott Osborne may have missed the kick, but very well gets the knee. And we see a running knee.
Wow, I'm just as surprised as you got, Penny. Predicament.
Now going for the pin. One,
two. A kick out, and you can see the.
And no, just ever so close.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
This will definitely be, I believe, in contention for match of the year. Later this year.
What's he doing?
you see just that submission just on top. Now a powerbomb, a chair being chucked in the ring. One, two, and no.
He's still in this.
A kick out.
He's not going to like this. He's looking. This might be it. Oh my.
Elbow there.
He's going for the pin.
This will be it. One, surely two. And no. A kick out.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. Harsh impact.
And a hip drop onto that arm. An elbow.
Gets the tag.
Referee's seen the chair and chucks it out the ring.
No, there's the reversal.
You see, swinging STO. Now as he looks to finish things off with a kick. AJ Reese. And Philip Sheffield once again getting involved. You'll have to, should have paid attention to the match.
Suplex. Oh, look at this. Second suplex. This is not going to be
these
good.
Underhook suplexes. AJ Reese.
He's
trying to get that tag, and he does.
Momentum has certainly shifted.
And an Enziguri. Another Enziguri.
This is what makes him.
Sure, another third in nose.
Lightning fast reflexes.
He gets that kick there. Drop kick.
I think I felt the ground shake on that one.
Now on the outside of the ring. Punch after punch.
Three.
Bouncing him off the apron.
Another great tag team match here tonight. I don't think the tag team scene has ever been hotter here.
Now in the ring. When this once again.
On, look out.
What we see here is he picks him up and package power driver, which is pretty much how Virgil defeated him, and I wouldn't be letting this tag go. And he gets a tag.
Oh, he needed that in the worst way.
And a kick there, another knee. Knee to gut there.
And it's moves like that that make him so dangerous.
Another knee to gut is the way he went over the top, and a kip up. And a drop kick.
Nailed it.
Raking at the eyes. A German suplex.
But that's not.
Clothesline.
Here's his moment, Michael.
Turns him inside out. One, two, and the referee get taken out once again.
He might have it.
Now into a submission.
He looks to be losing a bit of leverage here.
Into a submission, and of course the referee. Not up, so it wouldn't have mattered if Justin tapped out.
I can't believe I'm going to say this, but I'm with you, Cole. So unbelievable that he broke out of that. Make your
and knee to the head.
Looks like we got a quarrel brewing. The ref's got to nip this in the bud.
And Philip Sheffield once again getting involved. I don't know why the referee hasn't ejected him yet. And look at the blood on the face of Scott Osborne. Blood pouring from that cut.
I wish I could tell you guys what this superstar thinks of this week's power rankings, but when I ask, the only thing.
Don't know what Justin Kendrick is doing. Maybe catching his breath or something, but I wouldn't be taking my time around the prestige.
Despite having an impressive spot in this week's power rankings, I'm told this superstar isn't all concerned with things like that.
That punch to the back.
There he goes.
And we see that stomp.
This one's over, guys.
The referee getting distracted once again.
And now one more time. What impact to think.
DDT and cause the referee distracted.
He's barking about something now.
This is uncalled for.
This is getting ridiculous. I don't know why this referee hasn't done anything. The blood on the Matt Bailey.
He's in control.
Blood on the face and the chest and knee. Now is Justin Kendrick looks to set up again.
This is gonna be bad. Watch the
And Philip Sheffield once again getting involved. Surely this referee is gonna eject him. This is getting out of hand. The numbers game.
Taking on any more damage here could very well mean the beginning of the end.
Now into a submission.
I don't think he's got it completely locked in.
And knee.
He breaks it.
He may have broken free, Cole, but I assure you the damage has already been done.
And an enziguri there.
We've seen this before.
And AJ Reese. Over the end, and no, he misses.
Oh, nasty impact. Tagged in.
Elbow drop.
Got the reversal.
Oh, a debilitating elbow drop.
The end may be near. Is he done?
Now in a submission, be able to get out of it.
Oh, and he finds a way to escape.
Wow. Cole, I think this entire arena had written him off, myself included.
Oh, boy.
I don't know how long these can go. And Matt Bailey, good night after that kick. Philip Sheffield, once again, surely not. He's getting involved.
Great job by him there, realizing where he was in
place. This referee, you think, would eject Philip Sheffield. I mean, Philip Sheffield playing smart by not letting them lose, but how much more damage can these two men take? He's talking smack there, talking trash.
Many matches absorbing punishment like that.
Nailed it. When this guy's on,
and he's bouncing him off the ropes. And a shoulder right to the gut. And an overhead spine buster. And of course, the referee knocked down.
He's fighting back here.
I expected nothing less.
A reversal there.
Comes in off the tag.
A tag here. And drop kick.
Full Nelson applied. You got him, Vince.
And a suplex. And come on. Philip Sheffield once again getting involved. Eject him already. I'm begging the referee at this point to eject him.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
And me, no, not able to get it. It's the second time that knee has gone into the turnbuckle.
Suplex, but that's not all.
Now, clothesline.
What a combination.
Good night.
Could pin his opponent.
One.
It's over.
two. A two count there.
Oh, and he reverses it. Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. Oh, the back of the mat.
The referee, I think, has well and truly lost control of this matchup. This dude, Matt Bailey, just stares over the AJ Reese.
Because of action like this, he's calling for it.
A German suplex.
But that's not all.
Another clothesline.
Lariat, what a combination. Games, here he goes for the win.
One. And Justin Kendrick there to break it up.
To me, like these superstars are running on fumes.
And a reversal. Now an Irish whip.
Boom, what impact. Gets the tag.
Tag is made.
Elbow finds
his mark. Elbow drop.
Here we go a second time.
And a stomp.
Can he finish him off here? Second time?
I don't think Matt Bailey can take much more. I mean, Philip Sheffield's keeping him in this matchup nonetheless, but what damage is he doing to Matt Bailey?
He might have it. What a cup. He's got him covered. One, two, three. They got it.
And Deathsaw pick up a win. What a win this is.
These guys getting after
they showed that they are not to be messed with. The numbers game definitely came into an advantage for the Prestige, but didn't help them pick up a win. I think it was kind of obvious after a while that Deathsaw were going to win this matchup. They were just dominating the Prestige. Matt Bailey will surely need medical attention. What a win.
The real deal, Justin Kendrick.
Big win despite absorbing a huge amount of punishment there.
I knew these two were a great team.
These two will definitely be in tag team contention.
They really impressed me out.
Well, tag team title contention.
an absolutely big fight feel in the arena tonight for this one.
Yeah, and judging from the vibe here currently, it seems to me like this is the one this sold-out crowd came to see.
Each of these competitors looks to gain momentum with a win tonight.
Whoever gets the early advantage could take this thing to a win.
Settle in, guys. This is going to be a blast to watch.
And I can't help but wonder how the champ's game plan differs, if at all, knowing that the title is not on the line here tonight.
Oof! Ooh, what impact.
Yeah, Ross,
this will damage your back.
You gotta believe this one's over.
He's moving like a man possessed.
Oh, flying forearm
on the mark.
What a stomp. Good grief.
We may be looking at a power bomb here.
That's exactly what it looks like to me, Cole.
Here's a cover.
Two.
And he kicks out.
I don't think his opponent was expecting that.
He's on the defensive here. I don't think he expected to be in this position here.
I wouldn't call for the medics just yet.
Wow.
He still appears to be in pretty good shape here.
Yeah, but if you count him out now, guys, you'd be making a very big mistake. Mark my words.
Oh, continue.
We know what's coming here.
Ooh.
This might not have been a wise move for him here, Michael.
And he escapes the submission.
And good thing, that could have been disastrous. Oh boy, he is rolling.
This is going to be big, one way or another.
Boom, what impact.
Here he goes.
Nailed it.
But he's got to capitalize now.
Looking for all the glory here. He gets his shoulder up before three.
Still too fresh.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
Man, what a slam. Oh, what a snapmare.
Oh,
perfectly executed.
Look out, look out.
Harsh impact.
This might be it, guys.
Shoulders on the mat. This guy's a competitor. He's not going down yet.
He isn't going to go away that easy.
Oh, man!
I don't
don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
Incoming. Oof. Going for the big one.
Nasty impact. Now he's got...
We've got a cover. It's going to take more than that to keep his shoulders down.
That would have been a shocker.
He's looking at it. Hooked up. The kiss! Sister Abigail!
The succubus strikes again.
He's going for the pin.
And there's the kick out.
He showed up here tonight for a fight, and that's exactly what we are seeing.
What a stomp!
Good grief!
This beautiful technique. Uh-huh, it's over! He's flipped the script here. This is what makes him one of the best in the business. This is it.
But he's running on fumes here. Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
He's looking for the win. Some of the action from the previous match.
This was another great moment.
He ain't playing here. Almost forgot about this one.
And I always enjoy watching him perform.
Here is your winner, the Reaper, Jack Mortis Char.
Big singles win here, guys.
To get the pinfall victory over such a high-quality opponent is incredibly impressive, Michael.
What a thrilling main event. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. Have a great night.